Welcome back, everyone, to Let's Play Max Payne. I'm your host, That Guy. And to be honest, I completely forgotten where we're up to in this. I've been uploading recently, but I've completely forgotten what chapters we've actually been doing in them. We're up to part 3, chapter 4, actually. Garage scene, a bit close to heaven. And chapter 4 is called Backstabbing Bastard, BB. Turns out that BB was a good cop. But my hands weren't actually on the keyboard there, so I didn't really care. Why is he sliding backwards? BB was one of your informants, but yeah, basically he betrayed you. Pressed too many times. These guys aren't BB, in case you're wondering, these are just random goons. So, yeah. Once again, I have a whole bunch of things happening on my computer while I'm doing this, so hopefully everything will be alright. It turns out that the uploads I've been doing haven't always been working, which has kind of annoyed me a lot. Takes a pretty long time to upload, and then you find out that right at the 99 percentile, nah, it's not acceptable. So, frustration, it's all the rage, I guess you could say. Oh jeez, was he limping? He is limping. Ah, that's to signify that you're injured, obviously. Basically, from what I remember, you need to go all the way down the garage. I don't know how many floors there are, but it's gonna be a lot of this kind of garbage. It's amusing. I mean, like, you know, when you have these kind of games, obviously you need to have some sort of health bar system. But also, I just realized that they gave him a limp, which is a kind of weird way to signify that you're injured. I mean, fair enough, it does suggest that you are injured in the first place, which is enough, but a limp? Like, there's a lot of choices in injuries you could have had. Even just a screen going red. Back then they didn't have that though, because they just would have ticked off a lot of people. Which is true. But yeah, so he just walks with a limp. Oh! Hello. There's supposed to be machine gun fire coming out of it, but alright, they're not targeting you anyway, so it's not that bad. I probably shouldn't use so much the cop command though, because, well, these enemies don't have cold commanders. So, I'd have to actually basically just find the ammo for it. How am I on ammo on it? About halfway, so. I'll save that in case I do come across any, balaclava stricken guys. In case of fire, do not use elevators. Use stairways, which is ironic because that's probably a stairway. Just give me 1 second. Sorry about that, everyone. One of my mates just came by and provided me with some food, quickly dropping it off. In case you guys haven't seen the previous videos, I actually said that for the first 20 subscribers, they'll go into a draw with a chance to win Tim Tams. That's why. So, feel free to subscribe. It's more to speak that I have leftover Tim Tams, or an excessive amount of it, because one of my mates actually works at the Tim Tam factory. So, yeah, there's nothing wrong with him. He just has a lot of them, and he figured, like, what better way to promote my channel. We probably won't do it very often, because he kind of just constantly steal these Tim Tams. It's not stealing. It's what they call quality control. Quality control, I believe he calls it. So he can just say things are faulted when they're not. So, sounds a bit dodgy now I think about it. But he says it's perfectly fine. I do have a friend that works at a Coca-Cola factory, but it'll be a lot of trouble trying to transport that overseas to you guys, so I'm not even going to try that. Transporting liquid, that's just, yeah, not happening. Because even on planes these days, you can't transport liquids anyway, so basically it's a bad idea, because basically with explosives on planes, I believe this is how it happened, which is why they don't have they don't allow you to carry much liquid on board. Is basically there's these things called binary compounds. So these are types of explosives that I'm talking about here. But basically, you have two substances. Both of them are completely safe when separate, but the moment you mix them together, they become like really bloody dangerous. So, yeah, when they refer to you can't. Well, these guys have compounds. Basically, that's the whole idea of it. That's why you're only allowed to carry a certain amount of liquids on you when you're on a plane. So, it makes sense. I can't believe it took me that many tries to get this bit through. But I'm pretty sure it works with the post service as well. Like, you can't just transport liquids, but I don't like to transport liquids in anyway. I mean, maybe... I got a friend that loves Dr. Pepper, and... I could get it some sent from overseas. Sent by the manufacturer, but I'd really rather not do that. I'd rather just get it sent in-house, because the last thing I want to do is pay for something online and then not get it, because it's part of the Patriot Act. But as I said, it can't hurt you. They're not even shooting you. So. Right, there is one guy down there. I want to try something I haven't done in a while, and let's see if we can snipe him. Shit. Bam, right in the kidney. In the stomach. Yeah, I don't find sniper weapons that useful in this. Don't get me wrong, scoped weapons are good, but there is such a thing as ineffective range, as they call it. If you're not in the right range, say, well, I guess a perfect example is using the Ingrams at full length away at someone all the way down the end. It's not worth it. It really isn't. Like, you spend more ammo wasting it on... I wasted a lot of ammo there, actually, speaking of which. I think that aim assist is kicking in there, because they realise that little shit at it. Oh, man. Oh, that's a normal dodge. That's bullet time dodge. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Look at those scorch marks there. Crap. There's a guy there, actually. If you can just barely see him on screen, he's basically behind that pillar that's unblocking right now. You can see him? Clever bastard. Hid next to an explosion. There are a lot of guys in trench coats. What, the trench coat's the latest thing these days now? Like, I don't know anyone that owns a trench coat now that I think about it. I mean, I wouldn't mind having like a Neo-style trench coat, not necessarily in that kind of off-green colour that he has, but a black one. But, yeah, be cool. Just for style. No real reason. Look at this, look how much damage I've taken. I'm just gunning these guys down. It probably is easier to play with, like, you know, no health, basically. with Van, see the door slightly open, means I can interact with him. You got a COG commando there, come on, let me pick it up. There we go. R, for reload. If any of you have played Kingdom Hearts, you'll know that's Zigba, who's one of my favourite enemies. And of course, he has dual handguns. Zigba, that is not. I wasn't really paying attention to that guy just then, so... Oops! Oh, I didn't realise that they could basically stick their arms in front of each other and just do the double-headed ogre type attack. Look at that. People were just dying all over the place. It's a good feeling. Yeah, I might actually just play with having this little amount of health, because the amount of damage that they're doing anyway is huge. Gonna come up? computer doesn't know what to do. Everybody dance now. Da, 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 da. We'll join in as well. I was gonna... Oops. Bad throw. Oh, I don't think I can even throw that far, actually, now I think about it. That's pretty far away. Oh, I'm empty anyway. Crap, it's fire. Ooh, Ingrams. Man. Speaking of which, I've only got one anyway, so if I kill him, I'll get a second one. First thing I want to do is just shoot a lock off. I hope you guys are watching this in full screen, otherwise I just did something that you guys wouldn't be able to see. It's locked. No, it's not. That seems weird. I didn't even need to press the action button for that. They can't get through on our side anyway, so it's okay. Oh, wrong hit effect. I was supposed to fly backwards, not, you know, that direction. Go, 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 go! Go, go, go! Oh, it's just the amount of time it takes for you to get back up. It's just... Go, 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 go! Grenade! Look at him go! Yo! Whoa. The problem is, I try to make sure that I put just enough bullets into one person, but the problem is, because it's so far away, when you're in bullet time, it takes a while for the bullets to get there in the first place, so... Yeah. Overkill usually is the best answer, though, I must admit. Like, I think that's how I get killed a lot in gaming in general, because like, I'm not using all the bullets I possibly could. Ooh! Shit! Huh. It is actually easier to do it with lots of damage taken already, it seems. No, I did die then, but not bad. 7 shots left. Not enough to worry about. A lot of cars screeching in the background. Toodle, do whatever steps necessary. Deputy Chief Jim Bravura. I'll say it for him. We're gonna hear it anyway. Obviously there's a radio that we can interact with soon. Need your clothes, your keys, and your motorcycle. I think someone's about to come up here. Yeah. Damn it. Yeah, this game, obviously, the amount of damage that everyone does is really high, and they take a lot of damage. Reports of a fire at Punchinello Manor in Wedge. Westchester, the manor is the home of Angelo Punchinello, the alleged head of the Punchinello crime family. The police are now saying, contrary to their earlier statements, that Max Payne is still alive and at large. He continues his vendetta against the mafia, which last act of arson is attributed to. I had no recollection of setting any fires, but I do remember the flames, which is true, because we didn't actually set it on fire ourselves. But, you know, who's going to believe us, really, when you think about it? I must say, I am thoroughly enjoying this game, even though there is a lot of death, only because I'm really actually quite bad at playing this, or at least on PC version. Okay. Ooh, hello. How are you today? I hope you're doing well, now that you're bored with bullets. Oh, what a time to save as well. Everybody dance now. Oh, that was a Molotov. Someone threw a Molotov all the way back there. Okay, I don't know where the enemies are. When you don't know what to do, cheat! Duel Ingrams! Oh, this didn't work out well. Oh yeah, it did work out. Considering that these bullets just shower the area, it's not really a bad choice, really, because you're bound to just get one headshot, really. Look how many bullets that is. That's, I mean, I've just used, what's that, nearly 200 bullets, I think? Yeah, nearly 200 bullets. So, yeah. Oh, well, that's, this isn't gonna happen, is it? Hit him once, but once doesn't mean much. Let's just go to the right straight away, huh? Make more sense. Yeah, this is how you play the game. Lots of bullet dodging. Shooting up other people's cars. People with shotguns. And another one with a shotgun, but I don't know where he is. There he is. I can hear it, but the problem is it's got like an echo, so I can't really tell where they are though. Is that him? Are you the one that's been shooting me the whole time? Or you're the one that killed me in the end, so I guess so. Again. I know I've got painkillers, but this is actually a lot more fun doing this one. You guys get to see more death. More death is needed. A lot more death. Actually, that's a health cabinet there, so I might as well use it next time to throw it. Just doing outlines of people, hope you don't mind. Okay. The most that a med cabinet can hold anyway is 4, so I'm just going to use 4 right now. And I think the most painkillers you can hold is 8. But if you are playing it through and actually have more than 8 or more, you're doing something very well. Either you're doing a critical playthrough like I seem to be doing all of a sudden, or basically you just know how to play the game. Yeah, I have to admit, I don't agree to all those people that do playthroughs of games, which there's like a billion of online. I mean, my Mega Man X one, as I said, that's only a trial run. That was just me testing it, and to be honest, I used Hypercam on that, and I'm not happy with the results of it. Just seeing how much glitchiness there was in it, to me that's unacceptable, basically. I have to give it a fire, because otherwise you will have the Everybody Dance Now theme song in your head. So, what's back here? Oh, random guy all the way back there. He's gonna somehow kill me. What do you reckon that is? A good 40 meters? Maybe, no, easily more than 40 meters. Look how many parking spots there are. Of course it's more than 40 meters. It's an explosive barrel you're hiding behind, buddy. Maybe I should zoom in more. This is the thing I hate about it. You can't just... At least I hit the grate. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. A boot. Sorry if you're... Oh, it's not freaking... I got tricked. Everyone seems to enjoy shotguns here. As I said, on previous games where they just die in one shot, the pump-action shotgun is like the best weapon. Sorry, the sawn-off shotgun is the best weapon. Actually, there is a better weapon than that, but we still haven't got it yet. So. It's not a rocket launcher, in case you're wondering. This. It was Max Payne Day for him. or Payne to the Max if you're one of the Finito brothers. It's funny, like, I don't know if you just saw that, but Max was facing left and when he fired his shotgun, but the bullets went pretty much in the direction I was aiming at. Something I always find amusing about this game. Yeah, so if any of you have seen this game Stranglehold, it's not a very... it's a fairly fast game, but it has Max Payne elements in it anyway. But the problem is, there's actually like this, they get the same as this, where there's a bullet time bar. There's a bullet time bar and there's a... I can't remember what's called. That's BB. And he's got the gun I was talking about, the different from all the other ones. Basically there is like, well, I can only explain it as a super bar, I guess. It does seem like when you fill it up, you do ridiculous things with it. Most of the time you use it for healing though. But there's one that allows you to rapid fire any weapon without worrying about ammo restrictions, which is pretty good. There's one that just kills everyone, but if you're doing it against bosses, it only does like a really pitiful amount of damage, which, to be honest, isn't a surprise. That's not BB. Sorry. the jackhammer. Basically, this is an auto shotgun. In the second one, they actually call it the striker, but yeah, it's... I can understand why they call it a jackhammer. Jeez, when it fires, it probably just like feels like it's ripping your shoulder or something. BB's in here somewhere. Grenade. Let's do it. We know what day it is today. You guys have the jackhammers as well. That's okay. Look at that. You can probably get like 5 or 6 shots out before you even land. At least. So that's a really bloody powerful gun. When I say powerful, I mean it does lots of shots, plus it does a lot of damage. So, that was weird. Let's try it again. That was dangerous. One more for good measure. Okay. Alright. He's at range, so best to use a long range weapon, obviously. Because he's so far away, I figured just, you know, just run in and just grab him. If he is using a shotgun, which I'm pretty sure he is, seeing that's the new weapon of the day, just go in and
Maxi. Come out wherever you are.
You're the one that's hiding, you idiot.
You know, I really hate people who refuse to see the inevitable. Refuse to do the smart thing.
Inevitable. Don't tell me he went around.
No, I must do the right thing.
Yeah, he ran around the other way. It's clever, really. So, there he is.
I blame you.
Did have a grenade. Oh, there it goes. And that should be end level, I think. End level? That's a phone. Gotta find the phone. Yeah. Max Payne? Whatever does it for you. Oh, this is Alfred Walden. I can give you the name of your enemy. Come to the Asgard building. Presently, we are expecting you. Click. A bit close to heaven. Chapter 5. In the Land of the Blind. I'm going to finish up as soon as this video clips over, so yeah, just give me 1 second. Walden was waiting for me on the steps of the old building. Mr. Payne, go inside. The others are anxious to begin. The others... Despite the general misconception, this building actually predates your city hall by 2 years, thus being the oldest municipal building still in use here at the foot of the Brooklyn Bridge. No kidding, like I care. The old man played tour guide as he led me through the dark domed hall. The answers I was after loom large ahead. Mr. Payne, I would like to introduce you to my colleagues in what we call the inner circle. You've been watching too much X-Files. You have seen the files on Project Valhalla, and we can fill the gaps, provide you with the information missing from those files. We were all involved in the early stages of the project during the Gulf War. What's the catch? We would very much like to blow this thing wide open, but our hands are tied. Her name is Nicole Horn. She was the key figure in Project Valhalla. When the funding was discontinued, she simply refused to quit. She knew exactly what she had in her hands. Nicole Horn is the president of Aesir Corporation. She has more than half the city in her pocket. This must be kept under wraps. If you try to go public with this, we will deny any knowledge. We need you to take her out. Afterwards, we can protect you. Make all the charges just go away. Like you should go away. That was a cue for killer suits to kick in the doors and swarm inside. Oh, great. Look how angry he is. Okay, saving here. Alright, I'm going to finish up here because I didn't set my timer. Good on ya. But yes, I hope that you enjoyed this, and I'll see you guys next time. Take care of yourselves out there, yeah?